jake nyorata engaian jake nyorat engai naomoni neningaian jake nyorat engaian jake
nyorat. Agar is short for African Agency for Arid Resources, and the name is quite self-explanatory. We started by focusing immediately and exclusively back then, which is 2 years ago, in the beginning of 2018, in commodities from arid and semi-arid lands. These commodities are namely gum arabic, frankincense, myrrh, and later on, last year, we started looking at aloe. Not aloe vera, everyone knows aloe vera. We don't have the vera species here. It can be planted, yes, but it's not an indigenous Kenyan species. There are many indigenous Kenyan species that do very well in arid lands and is a fantastic livelihood, just like the other ones as well.
After we collect these products from the communities of which we have collectors on the ground, we bring them to the Isiolo office, and where this Isiolo office is where we do our primary value addition, where we employ a women group or other people to do sorting and other grading as related to these products. And then now we sell the clean and sorted products to Nairobi and other places.
This is a seasonal business, the collection. So we mostly do our work between June and October, which is now. So if we were given an opportunity to resume this capacity building, we would definitely make sure that everything that is collected is bought.
Tukitrainiwa, tutakuwa na ujuzi sana ya kutoa hiyo agar na tuuse kitu kizuri. Juu kama una ujuzi, unaweza uza kitu kibaya. Na pale kwa kampuni itakuwa watakuwa na loss. Na pia mimi, biashara yangu itakuwa inaanguka chini kwa sababu hawatakujia tena. Lakini wakati nitakuwa na training ya agar, nitakuwa mzuri kwa sababu nitakuwa nauza, na hata mimi nitakuwa nafurahia mafuno yangu. Na pia community pia watakuwa nafurahia kwa sababu watakuwa naingia mstuni, wanatoa, wananiletea kwa wingi. Na wakileta kwa wingi, wakipata pesa yao, kazi inakuwa mzuri.
Ever since agar started working with the communities in the arid areas, we've seen a change in behavior, even behavior and economical change for these people. Because for instance, as we started, up to the moment we've bought goods worth over 6 million. This 6 million shillings translates into economical empowerment for these people here in the on the ground.
Sisi kwa kawaida huwa tunategemea tu kuuza mbuzi ili tupate kujikimu kwa chakula. Lakini sasa kama tunaweza pata njia nyingine ya pata pesa kama kuuza hizi aloe vera pamoja na hizi ubani, inaona ya kwamba community watanufaika sana. Sababu wakati mwingine hata mbuzi wanaweza kosa market, haswa wakati huu wa corona. Tuko na shida sana kwa sababu wakati mwingine hata tunakosa soko. Lakini kama tutapata njia nyingine ya kupata mahali pa kuuza hizi vitu, tutafurahia sana kwa sababu hizi vitu tumekuwa nazo tu watu tunatumia tu kwa matumizi yetu wenyewe. Kama hiyo aloe vera tunatumia kama dawa, na hii pia ubani tunatumia kwa matumizi mengine tu ya kinyumbani. Lakini kama itabadilika kuwa pesa, itakuwa mzuri. Nafikiri community wakisikia ya kwamba kuna mahali wanaweza uza, wataleta kwa wingi.
This grant, it was always thought really to empower communities. We would train and create employment for about 450 people. We would have these people divided between aloe farmers and collectors. So wild collection could give, we say up to, but it could be more depending on availability and how serious the group goes to the field to collect. The wild harvest, based on a minimum collection of 1 ton of each gum arabic and frankincense, which are both paid 150, that would give 300,000 per month per group, and the groups are five. So that's 1.5 million per group based only on wild harvest. Now, aloe in good season is harvested twice, both time at the end of the rainy season, after 1 year, yeah? This is after 1 year. So that would give a income of 30,000 per season, which is 60,000 per acre, and we're talking about 50 acres. That's 3 million. So after you have the first harvest, which is usually 1 year, 1 to 1.5, these farmers would have an income total of 3 million per year, just arriving from harvesting the aloe sap and cooking it with equipment that we would give in aloe bitter gum. And we buy the bitter gum to then resell it to buyers, either in Nairobi or in China. And that's the impact that we want to create. If given the grant would just go in capacity building, in equipment. Let's make sure that people understand that the acres of the farms, the aloe farms, they are all community owned.